Hey y'all, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Corey Ashton here at WebTegrity, and you have found our YouTube channel that is dedicated to all things WordPress. So every single Wednesday, I'm creating some sort of a video just like this to help you improve your online marketing, specifically in the world of WordPress. Super exciting! So be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel, check us out on Twitter, and head over to our website to find over 200 other videos all about social media marketing, search engine optimization, and of course, WordPress, how to improve your WordPress website. All right, so today's topic is kind of continuing our conversation that we had last week. Last week we were looking at, Google Snippets. So that's our video here, how to optimize your Google Snippets. That's to improve not only your ranking on Google, but also hopefully to increase the click-through rate so that people will choose your ad over a competitor's ad here in the rankings. So if you don't know how to do that, absolutely check out that video next. I'll be sure to put that link in the description box below so you can check out that video. But this week, I want to move us forward looking at more options for how to find the keywords that we need to be using. If you're familiar at all with WordPress and this channel, you know that I brag about this plugin all the time. This is Yoast, and in my opinion, it's the best free, and free is always in the budget, plugin for helping improve your search engine optimization on your website. Now, simply activating this does nothing for your website. Plugging it into your website, activating it, and utilizing the tools, allowing it to help you understand how to improve your content, is how this plugin could ultimately help improve your ranking. But inside of it is this little hidden gem that you might not know about, and that's what I want to show you today. How can we find the right key terms to use inside of our website? I'm going to show you an example here that we're looking at. We're going to go into a specific page on a website for a car locksmith is basically what this website is about, and we're looking specifically at one of the pages. Now, I'm going to shrink down a little bit here so as to not distract and so that you can kind of see the page. What I want you to see is this area right up here at the top of our website, all right? I want you to take a look up here and note that there's this section here. Now, I've already activated down here below, I've already activated my focus keyword. I already know that I want to be going for car locksmith, specifically in this page. I've already edited my snippet, which again, if you want to know more about this, that was my last week's video. So we've already done that step. Now I want to look at what are some other options? What are some possible variations of car locksmith? What terms should I be using? Well, right up here at the very top of each page has an option for additional keyword research, and it does take you out of your website, but it takes you into some pretty authoritative options here, which is obviously Google's. Let's slide off the page. Now, it takes that term that you plugged in your page. This is my key term that I added as a focus keyword, car locksmith. And it plugs it in right here, and then allows me to see a worldwide search result, and it gives me a range, which of course you can manipulate these things and change them. If we only wanted US, you can go in here and find the United States and just strip it down to that if you'd like, and ask it to please only result for the US or your country. So doing a search for car locksmith, there are a lot of people losing their car keys in Georgia and in our great state of Texas. You can see here that it's trending more there. You can also see some related queries. This is why it's so important to use this key tool, because you might not think to add in the term near me, which we are seeing trending very much right now. So car smith near me. Of course, Google is aware of your IP address, especially as you're searching on a mobile device or something like that. However, those that might be searching might specifically type in that term. If you've used that term, your page could have a higher opportunity to rank. You might not have ever thought of that. What about a 24-hour car locksmith, if that's your service? That's why it's so cool to come check out these amazing Google Trend resources over here, totally for free. And you notice I didn't even have to log into anything. So these are some top trending keywords. So that's a really cool tool. Another one sitting inside of here is the keyword research AdWords. Now, I'll note that you do have to have an account for this. However, it's a free account. So you just have to log in with your Google account and you can play around with their Google AdWords keyword planner. So that's what this looks like. And I was really impressed. I actually did a search for a totally different term for a totally different client, physician contract review. So that's my key term, and I wanted to see what Google AdWords might suggest as additional search terms. The other thing that's really spectacular with these results is that it gives me an option to see how many, a quantity of how much search queries are in place monthly, as well as it lets me know that there is high or low competition. It gives me an average what the suggested bid cost could be if I did want to run a paid ad for this. So here's what you're looking for in this area. I want you to see something really cool. I typed in physician contract review. It spit out physician contract review lawyer, which is exactly what my client is. It also gave me another option here that I thought was pretty cool, which was medical contract attorney. So a different little spin. But here's what I want you to see. It says the monthly searches on this is 50 as to compared to 20, and they're both high competition. So you might struggle a little bit if you're trying to have to pay for this, but organically you can go after these key terms. You can copy these, put them inside your website, and hopefully improve your content so that you're outranking your competitor. Is your mind blown yet? If this is too complicated, just slow down, pause me. I know I talk quickly. That's some of the feedback y'all give me, I know. But you can always pause this, go back and watch it again. You can spend time with me, book an appointment with me, get over to our website, learn more about how to do SEO on your website. These are incredible resources that you're able to use totally for free. And I highly suggest you learn how to use these. Now, over on our website, speaking of that, you can come over here to resources and go to classes and training. And on here, I have an SEO class that I produced. It's about 45 minutes, and it literally teaches you how to optimize your entire website, how to evaluate your current content, and see if it is going to rank high inside of Google. All right, y'all, this is it. And we're going to continue this series, I think. We're getting really great feedback on SEO topics right now. So stay tuned next week for another great video. Be sure to subscribe. And if you have questions specifically about finding your key term, or if you want your website evaluated, shoot me a link over here on our website. Come over here, shoot me your website link. I'll take a look at things for you. I'd love to hear from y'all. I hope you're having a great WordPress Wednesday. Bye, y'all.